Hi, my name is Adib bin Ibrahim. I'm a mechanical engineering student, and today I would like to present to you about my portfolio presentation. Currently, I'm in semester 3, and I'm currently studying an engineering module called Multidisciplinary Engineering Design. Multidisciplinary engineering means that every engineering student, especially mechanical and electrical, we have to work together and perform an engineering task. Right? So in this module, there are 6 learning outcomes that we have to achieve and learn at the same time. First of all is sustainability. Another one is evaluation method. Third is applying engineering physics. Fourth is appraise and defend ideas. Fifth is predicting outcomes. And last but not least is presentation skills, which is what I'm doing now. Okay, let's first talk about sustainability. So what is sustainability? Sustainability means that the act of us, whatever we are doing, we are preserving the resources for the future generations to come to use. So it means that whatever we are doing, whatever we are implementing, a project or anything, we are using it in a sustainable way where we use less but effective, and we preserve it at the same time. There's another saying from United Nations. Sustainability means that meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. Okay, so next slide, please. Sustainability. From what I learned throughout this module, there are 6 principal criteria that we have to apply in terms of sustainability. First of all is efficiency. Second is reduction. Third, equity. Fourth is skill. Next is sufficiency. And the last one is system. So when you talk about efficiency, it means that does your product is efficient enough to work? For example, a car engine, is it efficient enough to run 1 liter to undergo 100 kilometer travel? Is it efficient enough? That's a question. What do you mean by reduction? Reduction means that you try to use less amount of material into your project. For example, instead of using the whole board of metal into your car design, you actually leave out some space to in order to reduce. Another example is for iPod Shuffle. It is small. This shows that Apple company does not highlight into the size of its product, so that it does not deplete the world's resources. Third is equity. Equity means that when you manufacture and produce a product, do you pay an equal amount to those who contribute to your product? For example, does Starbucks pay enough money to those who find coffee for them? Based on the research, there are 3 countries that contribute the most coffee to Starbucks. They are from Vietnam, Philippines, and Thailand. Okay, next is scale. Scale means setting the size of the product. It's similar to reduction as well. And last is sufficiency and system. When it comes to system, it means that when you produce a product, you have to interconnect with the life to the person who use your product. It is similar as habitat, animal habitat. If there's no paddy, there's no eagle. It's a cycle. So when you produce a product, it can be recycled. It's a cycle towards, it goes back to your nature. So, next slide, please. So the next one is next learning outcome is applying engineering physics. What do you mean by applying engineering physics? It means that it's a study or application where we combine physics, engineering, and mathematical methodology into engineering applications. There are many reasons why we need to learn about engineering physics. One of them is it provides more thorough grounding applied physics. It also creates engineering solutions, and it also helps with research and development. For example, in school, you are being taught of Bernoulli's principle. Well, there are actually a reason why you need to learn. Without Bernoulli's principle, there is no invention of aeroplane today. That's the use of physical engineering physics. So in terms of my project this semester, where we have to create a car where it can sense an obstacle and stop, here we apply Newton's first law, where it means that any object, it will remain stationary or moving in a straight line in a constant velocity unless there's a force x to it. So for this, we apply this law into our ultrasonic sensor, where we equate it as based on this diagram, where it will sense the obstacle and it will stop. And you also use the equation of s equals to ut, originally from s equals to ut plus half ab squared. So let's move to the next learning outcome, which is evaluation of methods. What do you mean by evaluation of methods? Evaluation of methods means that your effort in approaching different kinds of design parameters. So when you identify your parameters, you have to compare the methods that you have chosen. Not just that, you have to decide what method is the best from all the methods that you have identified. Not just that, besides, once you have identified and everything, you have to plan and organize your chart in your project so that all the tasks are being distributed equally among your members. Lastly, you have to plan a Gantt chart so that the progress of the project is being monitored from time to time. So, next slide please. So how do we implement evaluation methods? So in my project, what we did was, we asked questions so that we can look into the problem statement. So how do we ask questions? We conduct a survey. As you can see from the first picture, we asked a few surveys to few engineering students, and one of the results that you get is that they are more concerned on so that our system does not interfere with the driver's decision. Once we get the surveys, we collect the data, and then we create an organization chart where we distribute the tasks, and we also create a Gantt chart, and last but not least, we choose a material. So as you can see, the material that we have chosen, we decided to apply sustainability so hence we look into materials from the storeroom, any used materials so that we can reuse them back. So let's move on to the next learning outcome, which appraise and defend ideas. So what does it mean? Appraise means you create your own idea. Where does your idea comes from? And you evaluate all your design parameters based on the project's friendliness, business value, and technical viability. Not just that, you have also considered the manufacturing, the cost, and the sustainability of the project. So how will you implement this? So in order to create ideas, we had a session where we had brainstorming, where most of our members gather together and brainstorm and produce ideas time to time. So as you can see from the picture, we produce ideas during the brainstorming session. Once we have done that, we undergo evaluation through six thinking heads, where it is being categorized into the overview category, the information, the benefits of your ideas, the creativity of your ideas, ideas that touch the feelings, and ideas that relate to negativity. So these ideas have been grouped into its categories. So let's move on to next learning outcome, which is predicting outcomes. Prediction is an ability to forecast something that could happen in the future. Okay? It also means that you give a hypothetical idea to what to expect as a result of your task or your project. Well, in prediction, it's very, it takes so many kinds of consideration as prediction may not be true most of the times. So, next. So how do we predict? So we predict, we have to basically consider a lot of criteria, which are environmental, human safety, economical aspect, as well as beneficial wise. For example, in today's mobile phone industry, Apple have designed an aluminium made handphone, and it's safe to use. And one of the examples that of a handphone company that does not relate to beneficial cause is from Virtu. As you can see, this phone is being made of gold, so it does not it's not very friendly to the market wise. So in terms of our project, as you can see, we predicted our car design as this earlier stage. So as we progress, as we found materials and so on, we try to manipulate a little bit of the design, and from what we have now is like this. So as you can see, there's rubbers that we used from previous projects, and some metal boards, and reused Tamiya motor. So basically, these six linear counts, as a conclusion, is that as an engineer, we have to work together with other engineers from different majors, and there's a lot of consideration to be taken when we do a project, such as we have to look into sustainability, environment, and as well as business-wise and market friendliness. So that's about it. Thank you very much. Yes.
Can we go back to slide number 6?
6. This is 60.
6. Yes. Something wrong on this side. Can you find out?
Is it this one? The arrangement of the alphabets?
Something. I'm not talking about the words, about the something wrong. And I read this, actually, something wrong here. So,
picture of it, you know, is it a definition?
He answers it,
yeah. Is it the definitions?
No.
The diagram?
No. Harry used this equation, but he wrote this correctly, but you didn't write this correctly.
Oh, sorry. It has to be sent to Jason. What? It's 0209. Go back and go there, so it's 2S.
0209.
So actually, when you want to calculate distance, you must divide by 2, right? Because
yes.
one back.
Correct.
So this is one thing. I saw that for your presentation, actually, you didn't give any content at the beginning, and also you didn't show any conclusion.
But I say probably.
Yeah, you just present, but it's supposed to be written. The presentation. Very important for the people, simply they also want to have some, let's say, conclusion idea, okay, why you get this and so on, okay? This slides can be actually organized. I see there is no good organization for the slides. The fonts, the background is all okay, but I mean by organization, this is what I actually just now mentioned, the introduction, the as a difference, for example, you introduce yourself, while Harry didn't introduce himself to the audience, okay, so it's also a good point for you, okay? That's all I have. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay. I have your paper. Next.
Sorry,